Look for the white lair. Okay, so how far away is this? Okay, and that's not far from the Manticore gear. So I'm thinking we'll go maybe check that out. I'm not sure. We will check out here, the Manticore gear, and then head on down, maybe. Yeah, I think that is a pretty solid plan. Right then, let's get going. Right, so we're going to head off to this cave and see what all that was about. Once that's done, then it's probably time to go catch up with Regis. We follow the road somewhat. I think we do a bit of cross country. We've got another one of these misty mornings, which I quite like actually. Somewhere this sort of warm. Yeah, you're going to get a few. Not sure what's over there. It's probably not wolves. Normally it's wolves, but round here it's panthers. Little house. Yeah, people just getting on with their own stuff. So, okay. You friendly? Yeah. What I haven't seen yet is a lot of unfriendly people running around wanting to kill us like they did in Velen. Just about everywhere you went there was bandits on horses. Whereas Toussaint, a little more civilised. Yeah, that wants me to go up that way. How far off are we? We're a million miles away. I suppose we could follow that road and use the actual path. That would make sense. Yeah, okay, we will do that. So I was thinking about armour. At the moment, Geralt's not exactly colour coordinated. Not that that's something he would probably worry about. So what I was thinking was, why don't we do the everything in black? That's a dye remover. But if we, I don't know if we can actually make any dye on foot. Probably can't. Black dye, Negredo. Okay, let's have a look. Can I make some Negredo? Yep. Okay. And can I do it here? So, if we dye both of them black, would it all match? Have a look. If I put that on, that's kind of cool. And then let's go back to alchemy. Probably need Negredo again, won't I? Okay, and then dyes black. What am I missing? Dye solution. Ah. Okay, I probably can't make that though. No, I've got a load of it in our stash, so we could maybe do that later. But we could drop grey on it. We've got dye remover anyway. If we don't like it, we can take it off, but let's. Yeah, I think those in black, they look a bit monochrome. I was thinking the black might be a bit darker than it actually is, if I'm quite honest. So, yeah. Not to worry. New marker. Glensare Farm. Oh, you might say that now. You may not say it later. Or, you know, maybe you will. Yeah, there was no quest marker for that. It's just a place. Now, I don't know what to expect down here. I know the road's over there, but maybe we can go this way a little. sounds like panthers for a start. So, okay. Maybe we need to deal with panthers. In which case, I don't like fighting animals, you know, just regular animals. I always feel we're kind of, well, not helping. Yeah, I think these are what the game has decided we have to defeat. Yeah, I don't think there's a way to avoid these guys, unfortunately. So let's have some tawny. And or maybe we can. Looks like I didn't need them.
The cave Merton mentioned. Need to look around.
Yes, we do. Now let's look for a marker. I don't know how big this cave is. One thing I do know, it's probably very dark. What have we got here?
Slips of paper all over. Prayer on each one. Maybe Merton left one too.
Okay, so do we... Nothing to fight then? Can we light those? We're nowhere near it, but if we... Apparently no. Remember to seek moderation in all things, in drink and victuals and the pleasures of the flesh. For whosoever shall abuse these pleasures shall awake next morn in great pain with a pounding head and a wilted member. Okay. So he's a very wise god, and they're leaving stuff to him. So okay, let's do a little reading here. Do not unto thy neighbour what thou thyself deemest unpleasant, unless thy neighbour hath done thee sorely wrong and rife with vileness where his deeds. Do unto others, but don't be a patsy. Examine. Please bless mummy with good health, great Labodia. Make her well, and make her never get so awful drunk again. Antoinette. Yes. I think that might be a self-inflicted illness. Oh, great Libodia. Make my fields yield bounties and save them from floods and drought. But only my fields, mind you. My neighbour has had enough luck of late. Garçon. That's coveting your neighbour's field, my friend. That's... Grass is always greener and all of that. Thou shalt always speak the truth, unless the truth is not well served by being spoken, in which case thou shalt lie. Okay, interesting. Let me be beautiful, shapely, alluring, and always youthful. And may lice gnaw on that strumpet Maria's fat hiney. Text smeared. Already asked Mitalel. I've been to the Druids and nothing, so maybe you, great Labodia. Oh, you're hedging your bets there. We'll hear my prayer. I want to be old, ugly, and fat, for I'm sick and tired of staring at all these fair folks. They're dull as dishwater. I, at least, aspire to be interesting. Quentin. Yes, Quentin. Well, you know, if you wait around, I'm sure it'll happen for you. Okay, there's a red one there. Ah! Merton's Prayer. Okay, 7th of Feren. Or Fien, no idea how you pronounce that. 1203. Bless me with strength that I may never falter. Bless me with grace that I may never doubt. Bless me with fortitude of spirit that I may leave behind the old and embrace the new with courage. I, Merton, a member of the Guild of Witches named after the Manticore, begin this day my pilgrimage here in the very cave where, for thee and 20 days, for 3 and 20 days and 3 and 20 nights, Labodia fasted and meditated. Why can't you just say, you know, about a month? I vow to atone for my sins, to walk the path of redemption and rid myself of all that ties me to my old life, so that I may stand proudly among the disciples of the highest and proclaim myself a new man. I shall thus now journey to the temple of Labodia. Oh, he's gone on somewhere else. To meet the great beggar, a sage who has pondered the pearls of Labodia more than any else in this sad vale of tears. I shall listen to his counsel and follow his guidance on my road to absolution. Basilisk. Yeah. Okay. Estuary. Oh yeah, did we not? I thought I'd read these. Okay. I tend to sort of read these off camera because there's so many of them.
There we are. Merton wrote a prayer on the back of the diagram. Seems he left the prison, came here, then went on to the temple.
Yeah, have I read these ones? Text me it. And may Jean-Luc be struck down in his bowels devoured by cholera, for he is a lecher and a harlot's brood like few others. Pretty petty, a lot of these, aren't they? Labodia, blessed be thy name. Please let my son Julian reach Corvia safely. Let him find a little lady at last, one well born with ample tracts of land. Okay, I think we've been all the way around, you know. Verily I say unto you, give alms to the poor. Alms for the crusade. Yet deposit not a whole watermelon upon a beggar's lap, but merely half, lest the beggar's joy strike him with apoplexy. I'm getting random XP. Right, I think, yeah, we started over by that urn, and we're now over here. Don't think there's anything in the middle. Now we've scoured round all of the walls, so I don't think there's any tunnels going off here. Go find all the diagrams in the set. 2 of 6. So have we actually found another diagram then? Let's have a look. Manticore boots, maybe? Nope. Manticore chest armor, maybe? I didn't see a diagram, I just saw his note. No, not seeing it. Not seeing it. Right, okay. Now back out the way we came, I guess. Although I might be stuck fighting those panthers now, I'm not entirely sure. Oh yeah. Probably am. Sword is bugged on me. Damn it. You're quick, you guys, aren't you? I'm running away. Yes, I am. No, apparently I'm not. Now I'm running away. Have we gone? Okay, that's maybe better. Right, so that's probably going to send me somewhere completely... Yeah, look, it's... miles up at the top of the map where we've not been. So I think we go back here. We go back to the lair. We go back on track. Which is a little further south. So we're back on main quest again. It's such a lovely place, isn't it? Ooh. big spider things. Do we want to kill big spider things? Probably do. Insectoid, where are we on there? 94%. Armor's at 93. That should be okay.
What? Lost your nerve?
Whoa! I don't know where the extra Quen is coming from. I think that might be... I think that is the set bonus. God, these things are hard to fight. Especially level 47 ones. We might be biting off more than we can chew. Ah, no, 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 no. See, they just run out of range of even extended. Well. Come on then. Nope. Am I going to have enough time to get a turret down, stop them with the webs? Come on! Oh god, there's another one back there. Come on! Okay. Oh. Well, the defense is working really rather well. Look. If I can avoid being hit, I will do an awful lot of damage. Ah. Stop running away! Stand there and be hit. Unlock. Okay. Oh. Okay, one down. One down. At least the block is working rather well. Ah, you swine. Ah. That block is working really well. Too well, almost. I need to check something in a second that we haven't mysteriously... Come on. Come here. Come here when I'm killing you. Hey, nice! God, those hits are getting really quite huge. So that's working out really well. I'm quite pleased with this build thus far. It's quite defensive, yet not stupidly overpowered, but some ways is. But I just want to make sure that things haven't... Yeah, yeah, there you go. Death March it is. Right, we've run out of insectoid oil. There's one left. So... Okay. Now, the turret takes care of the webs that they shoot.
So,
can I get one down? Yes. Yeah. Come on there. Come this way. Yeah, it's getting rid of the webs. Ah. That's interesting. Oh, God, that was a lot of damage then. Now, we should be getting more and more... no, we've lost the damage bonus, I think. Yeah, that was difficult to see, but the damage was definitely creeping up the more we hit on that. So yeah, this is working out quite well. Yeah, I can see. Interesting. There's another cave over there. I don't know if the cave has to do with what we're doing though. That's the thing. No, that's just... Oh, that's the cave we were in. Well, we got sort of off the beaten track there, didn't we? Is this going to be panthers? Because I don't want to kill them. They're noble creatures. Oh, hello. Big water underneath. Sounds like a lot of spiders to me and other stuff. Good night. Thank you. Spiders take rather a long time to fight. I can hear what sounds like wolves. Don't need Witcher senses to hear those guys. No, we don't. There's something on this junction that we're going to have to... Yeah, I think this is part of this. Look for the White's lair.
Bar guests. Never a good omen.
Okay, there... Are they spectres? Panthers. Yeah. Insectoids. Did we not have arachnomorphs before? I thought we did. Doesn't mention Erden, however. But definitely seemed to work. What's new here? Whites. They said the dead like quiet. I don't know about the dead, but whites certainly do. Heinrich von Grott. Though the whites are ghastly and threatening in appearance, one should not approach them with sword drawn or attack them unprovoked. Left alone, they present no serious danger to anyone and are far more interested in mixing noxious brews in cauldrons than fighting. This species mainly lives around ancient burial sites, though they have been spotted near more recently found cemeteries. And they are necros. Okay. Necro and Axi. Okay. Whites spend the winter months in a state of lethargy, very similar to human sleep. They live strictly solitary lives. In fact, it's practically unheard of for these creatures to appear in groups. Yet, when they fear their territory is being threatened, and it is enough for one to step foot in a white's territory for it to feel threatened, so it doesn't take much, whites transform into dangerous foes and even abandoned their solitary ways to summon monsters to their aid. So it's a bit like a lesson then. It is a certainty. But if a white finds itself in danger, it will immediately spew out an electroplasmic solution, which near instantaneously transforms into barghests. These beasts obey the right. So they're both necro, and it can spawn adds. So it's, if we're going to fight it, it's going to be tough, I think. How's our sword looking? 82. Let's just... Ended up with lots and lots of these again. Need to watch that. I didn't notice before. I was walking around with like 30 of those. Wondering come where... On. I think we just found it. Foglet. Are you joining in, or are you just going to wander off? Come on. Bloody foglet. Come on. Yeah, I'm over here. Whoop. Right, no, I saw you. That was a lot of damage. My god, this build's overpowered almost. Anyway, that was not what we came here for. Am I? Oh, there. Okay. Refresh Necro. I think we'll have Tawny and a bit more Necro. Might as well leave the sword out, actually. Oh, is that thing, or is that the Aggis? Aga? Wherever they are. They. Now, these guys are really not tough. They're high level, but they're, the dog things are just not that tough. Now, looking at that, there's... Now just, oh right, there's undiscovered. It's kind of, we'll go back and check that out once we figure out what's going on in here. There's an old house here. Can we explore the house at all? Is that part of the... not that way around. I think we're going to wind up sliding down a cliff if we do. Spoons! Many, many spoons. He said they like spoons. That's pretty creepy. So there's stuff down there, and then up here too.
Strange. Get a sense that the spoons are beating out some kind of rhythm. A message. Trying to tell me something.
Yeah, it's probably trying to tell you to go away. Got a door, though I don't think it'd be a good idea to open that door. That looks very propped up. Is that the same deal over here? Yeah, locked. Okay, I think we're going inside. Is that a good idea, just to walk straight in? Oh. Well, even if it's not, I'm guessing we are doing it.
None shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall say to you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror. Sounds like a curse, all right.
Yes, it does.
Somebody's clearly obsessed. Regis mentioned the place might be cursed. Can't be a coincidence. Need to look around.
Well, I was just saying that, but we seemed keen to just wander in. Yes, it's very creepy, but I can't interact with that.
A pigsty. Need to search it thoroughly.
There's a clue.
Collect some white saliva.
There's a clue.
White's obsessed. A real collector. Thoroughbred.
Okay, let's be systematic.
Spoon. Pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old.
Okay. It likes spoons.
Spoon's incredible. The craftsmanship must have graced a rich man's table.
Stained diary. Well, that's a big clue. Let's have a look. For a few days now, I've been having dizzy spells. I've never experienced anything like this before. If it carries on, although I can't stand witchcraft and sorcery, I'll have to visit a herbalist. The dizziness has not gone away. Worst of all, it's been joined by pain, so strong that at times I cannot see. I've been to the herbalist. A repulsive old crone looked at me like she had seen a monster. She gave me some cursed mixture that I have to drink twice a day. It's not helping at all. Today, like every day, I looked in the mirror and was lost for words. I usually check that I don't have any wrinkles or bags under my eyes, but today there were no wrinkles. But I'd rather that there were. I have hair growing on my breasts. It's horrible. It's got to be because of those damned herbs. I went to the herbalist to smash her face in. Would you not have just had words first? But her chambers were empty. She must have known what would happen to me and legged it. My family is starting to suspect something, although I am cutting the hair back, which is growing back faster and faster. I've tried to put the idea out of my head, but I can't hold it back any longer. Maybe it was the herbs that led to this, but a curse placed upon me by an old beggar whom I had to chase off one time. I have to find out. I want to hire someone who can find the herbalist. I cannot think, and it's getting hard to write. Loneliness, no family. Eat, I want to eat. Not a good spoon. Empty spoons. Nothing. Eat, it hurts. Mirror, lies. No. Okay, so yes.
Poor girl. Realized she was changing into a monster. Recorded it in her diary. Poignant.
So I'm not sure what the connection with spoons is, but it's an obsession thing, isn't it? Many spoons. Do we need that many spoons? Smashed mirror, is it?
Smashed mirror.
Yeah.
As if someone couldn't stand to look at themselves. The monster.
Deus Ex Human Revolution much? Okay, so we've done this corner. Let's...
No spoon you have shall sate you. Whatever lives here treated that literally. Still searching for the right spoon. Another spoon. Yep, just as normal as the last one.
God, that must be horrific. Constantly being obsessed with something seemingly so ordinary and yet not.
Skeletons. Doubt they came here willingly. This have anything to do with the curse? None shall sit and dine with you at your table. It'd make sense. Right arm bit right off. Teeth all knocked out. Somebody tried to force feed him.
Oh god. Decaying letter. Dear Master Lavasseur, I'm guessing on the pronunciation, I know you track outlaws for pay. I've an unusual assignment for you. No doubt you wonder why I have drawn you here, and why we cannot meet in person. You see, in my present situation, any kind of meeting is very risky. Not so much for me, as for the person with whom I meet, for I am afflicted by a curse, or, as I hope, and why I have turned to you, the side effects of medicine given to me by some time ago by a herbalist. That's some herb. Soon after I visited this herbalist, she disappeared without a trace. I desperately wish to understand my illness, so I wish to hire you to find her. When you do, learn as much as you from her as you can about the medicine she gave me. If my suffering is a result of her wickedness, then make her provide an antidote. I assure you that I have ample wealth and will reward you with no small part of it for your services. If it turns out my suffering is not the fault of the herbalist, please let her go. I will then have a different task for you, because this shall mean I am afflicted by a terrible curse which only the gods can cure. I believe it was cast upon me by a certain beggar who came by the manor while I was hosting a soiree for a few friends. If you can find that vagrant, I will pay you double. Sadly, all I remember of him is that he sold mirrors. Okay. Yes, we know someone that sells mirrors. I am aware this is not much to aid you for your hunt, yet I trust in your considerable talents and wish you the best of luck. I don't think we're going to be getting them out of this curse. Oh god, is he involved?
Woman's name scratched into this wooden spoon. romantic.
It's a Welsh thing. It's called a love spoon. Yes, really, it's a thing.
No claw or fang marks. Probably choked to death.
Did we not examine the one in the middle? I thought we had.
Broken neck.
Oh.
Indentation in the skull's lateral surface. Smacked in the head with something heavy.
Okay, can we read that? I'm not thinking we can. I wonder if that's him.
White's obsessed. Real collector. Thoroughbred.
Is it Odim? Is Odim involved? I think we've done this floor. There's a floor above. I can see the cellar. Yes, I can see the scary cellar. I think there may be. But I can't see any means to get to that floor. It might just be loft space, though. It is, isn't it? It's just loft space. Not an actual floor. Probably was quite... Oh, there's some... A missed one, did I?
Spoon key. Sophisticated crafting. Tag bears a description. White's a true collector.
Spoon key note. Read. Yes. Spoon key note. This certifies the item up for auction, an antique spoon key forged at the Christofferson and Sons workshop in 1210, belongs to Smeagol Circus. Andy Circus, who played Smeagol in, yes, Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit. Owner of the pheasantry. Okay. What's the quest for that then? Secondary? Treasure hunt, maybe? No. Spontaneous profits. Ask the owner of the pheasantry about the mysterious spoon. Yeah, interesting, but let's not get sidetracked that easily. Okay, I think we are going to have to head downstairs. Should probably dash home for some sleep first. Got all the bonuses. Waiting for things to trigger as I walk around, you know.
Oh. Actually does seem like a White's lair. Bit atypical, but still. Cauldron should be somewhere around here. Spoon, pretty ordinary, maybe a little old. Another spoon. Yep, just as normal as the last one.
Yeah, we're now getting very dark.
Oh, cauldron I was looking for. Why, it's not particularly tidy. White's obsessed. Real collector. Thoroughbred.
Okay, we're just finding a lot of the...
Table's set. White who lives here is getting ready for some sort of feast. White that lives here, definitely afflicted by a curse. And it's been trying desperately to lift it.
Well, maybe we could help them.
Cauldron's empty, unfortunately. We just need some brew. Afraid he won't get that. No choice but to hide and wait for the saliva glands and their bearer. Need a spot that'll let me observe the cauldron. Spoon, pretty ordinary. Maybe a little old.
Do you know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking, does it ever put these spoons in its mouth? Because wouldn't there be some saliva there? Need to find a spot to hide. Oh, God. I wonder if we'll find a magical kingdom on the other side. Okay. We've come to dinner. Now remember, this isn't a monster, it's a cursed person. We should try to help them. If we can't, then unfortunately... Yeah, oh my God. be pretty horrific to all of them. Got to remember inside, this is old Dim's doing. Just remember who did this to this person before you charge in there to hack them to pieces out of revulsion. Geralt seen a lot. Oh, well, I guess we don't get the choice. Oh, we do get a choice. We get a choice. Is this us walking out into the room first person, or...? Hello? We're friendly. Yes. Hello? Hello, good morning. No. Guess not. Oh. Oh, right, now we're in the room.
I'm not gonna hurt you. Wanna help?
Yeah. Friendly!
I've seen the words of the curse on the walls. Think I know how to lift it.
Don't be frightened, we're here to help you. No, do watch, being all helpful, being helpful. Look, picking up things. Look, I'm only picking up plates or bowls. Picking up bowls. Why am I picking up bowls?
You tried to bring folk here, convince them to sit at the table with you, right? Well, I'm gonna be your guest now, your willing guest.
Thank you. Yes, it's a chair. We're going to sit on the chairs and eat.
Just need a bit for Regis.
Okay, so we've got the white.
And
so we've done it.
We'll tend to you.
Okay. Right. Yeah.
I need to get this right. Words of the curse were: none shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall sate you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
Okay. Let's eat. That makes sense, but let's go through it. Let's swap spoons. Well, no. Because even if... Did he say it has to be her spoon?
Need to get this right. Words of the curse.
No spoon you have.
None shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall sate you. Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
Right, so it's don't eat with spoons, because if you swap, it becomes her spoon, doesn't it? If we use the spoons, then that's not going to work, because spoons! Right, let's eat not using the spoons.
We can't use spoons. No, that won't work. You've been looking for a spoon that would feed you, but there's no such spoon. We need to eat without spoons.
Hope they understand this. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Okay, come on. Yeah, like this. Bet this tastes absolutely lovely. Okay, something's happening.
Eyes. You need to see your likeness.
Okay. Geralt doesn't look very well. Well, something's happening. And I hope it's a good thing. Okay, we're pretty toxic.
Like I expected. Need to see what happened to the white. Won't be hard to find given its stench.
Okay, follow the white. Yep. Follow the smelly smell. Did we cure them, or have we just made this an awful lot worse and made Geralt very toxic? Hello? We're still friendly. Hello? Are we still friends? Okay, there's unfriendly stuff here. Hope we don't... Oh, we're going to have to fight them anyway after all that. Darkhurst. Can I avoid? Don't think I can. Necro. Come on. Be careful of potions we're taking because we are... Oh no, we've lost some of that toxicity. Where is it? There it is. Okay. We're going to have to fight another dog, yeah. Or maybe not. Okay, the dog things are not all that... They're not hugely problematic. We still going the right way? We are. I think that's her. Oh, Marlene. Have we... I think we've done it.
Shh, easy. Not gonna hurt you.
Eat. I must eat.
Well, at least you're human again. Ish. Well, yeah, you're human. You're just a little old.
I'll take you someplace safe.
Okay. She probably maybe had this curse for a long time. Because I think we managed to banish Odim. Oh, I've taken her back to Corvo Bianco.
So I took her by the hand and led her here. Seemed the only sensible place for her.
You did the right thing, sir. She should recover quickly here.
I'm glad he's understanding.
Don't worry, sir. I shall see to everything. She is safe here and in good hands. She'll soon be back on her feet.
Might actually take a while. She hadn't eaten anything in over 100 years when I found her.
Horrid. Whatever brought this about?
Yeah, she was cursed, mate.
Told me her story on the way here. Her name's Marlena. She was once the very beautiful and proud heiress to the Trastamara estate. One evening, when she was holding a banquet for friends, a beggar came to her gate seeking alms. He had a bowl and a spoon with him. He sat outside her fence and waited.
I've heard of the custom. An ancient rite of hospitality that obliges one to give food and drink to such a guest lest he depart hungry. To neglect the custom is to bring great misfortune down upon oneself.
I think it was Odem.
Didn't care a whit for the old customs. She drove the man off, saying she'd rather feed the leftovers from her feast to her dogs than to give the beggar anything. The beggar then broke his spoon, cast a curse. She was beautiful, so he said she'd never wish to look at herself in the mirror again, since she adored feasts. He swore no one would ever wish to sit and dine with her. And as she even refused him the crumbs from her table, he swore she'd never find a spoon in the world that would sate her hunger.
Oh, wow. A harsh punishment. I imagine lifting the curse was hardly simple.
Are we going to brag?
Curses are tricky. They play on irony. Always gotta figure out what the catch is. Marlena had spent decades looking for a way to lift it. Transformed into a white, she stole spoons and lured folk into her home, trying each time to get them to dine with her. Didn't work.
So what did?
Someone had to sit down and share a meal with her, of their own free will. They had to eat without using spoons, and make her look at her reflection.
That's it? That was all it required?
It sounds simple. It sounds simple now.
That come to mind. Besides, when you're a white, it's pretty damn hard to find willing human company for a feast.
I imagine so. But, most importantly, it is now over. Please, don't worry. She will be in good hands here.
This place, tell me more about it, or... Alright, so long.
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
Okay, well that... kind of ended well. How are we doing on renovations anyway? Where are we up to with that? Seeing as, you know, we are here. Talk 2 minutes. Okay. try talking to him again now we've finished that bit of dialogue.
Renovations coming along all right?
I am delighted to inform you we have completed our labors. You can now devote yourself to enjoying the vineyard's delights to the fullest.
Okay.
You must forgive me my temerity, sir, but I thought with all the work on Corfo Bianco completed, and with the estate looking more beautiful than ever, it might be appropriate to commemorate the moment.
Yeah, okay.
Sure, why not?
During the tidying that preceded the renovations, I came across a bottle of Sapramento, the 1250 vintage.
Got your eye on something?
I cannot say by what miracle it survived, but it is here. And we've course to open it today.
Okay. He's...
And
he's
then he ran straight into the crowd.
He's a decent enough guy, though, isn't he?
All thought it a part of the performance, so they only laughed, even when the decor began to catch fire. It was not until the flames engulfed Baron Mahefkin's beard that folk began to realize something was amiss and went to put out the fires.
Sounds like Monsieur Bolius and Madame Nina threw some first-rate balls here.
It was so. In this regard, Baron Drossel was decidedly more reserved.
So tell me, Barnabas Basil, what's the wine situation like here? Am I going to produce any this year?
This year is out, I fear, sir. Last autumn, a fungus destroyed all the vines. Baron Drossel had new ones planted, but it will be some time before they start bearing fruit. Assuming that is, the fungus does not reappear.
That'd be bad. This Sapramento got me dreaming. It's amazing.
Isn't it, though? Allow me to top you off, sir.
I think he's earned his bottle of plonk, to be fair. Okay. Quest updated. We have to go... Do we have to find pesticides now? We probably have to find pesticides now. Or is it done? It's probably done, isn't it? I think we've actually done that one. Awesome. Okay. So... Oh. I have a book. History of Corvo Bianco. So, yeah, it's not looking... overly splendid, but it is looking pretty nice. I have to say, I've got vineyards and whatnot, so it'll be a while before we actually get any wine or whatever from them, but you know, if we've got a big battle to go to, we have a night's sleep and we get all kinds of bonuses there, then I can sharpen up my blades and stuff. What I do want to do is the black dye. Why have I got red? I just saw red down here. Yes, I did. Can I... Why is that still red then? No. That's like meditating. All my potions get a... Yep, there you go, bombs and potions get an extra charge. So yeah, having this place is kind of really working out. I'm going to do the black armour. I'm going to do black again on the trousers. Then we're going off to meet with Regis. So I think things are going to get pretty interesting. Oh yes, I do.